गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास नाइन्थ चैप्टर नंबर 11 वर्क एंड एनर्जी स्टूडेंट इन द प्रीवियस फ्यू चैप्टर्स यू हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द वेज ऑफ द डिस्क्राइबिंग द मोशन ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्ट द कोज ऑफ द मोशन एंड द ग्रेविटेशन अनदर कंसेप्ट दैट हेल्प अस अंडरस्टैंड एंड द मैनी नेचुरल प्रोसेस इज वर्क एंड द क्लोजली रिलेटेड टू वर्क आर एनर्जी एंड पावर So student, in this chapter, what is the chapter name? Work and Energy, and this is the chapter number 11. So in this chapter, we will discuss these concept, work, energy, power. And student, you know, all living beings need food, and living beings have to perform several basic activities to survive. And we call such activities life process. And the energy for these processes comes from the food okay so we need energy for the other activities like the playing singing reading writing thinking jumping cycling running so activities that are require the more energy so if we talk about animals to get the energy in activities For example, they may jump and run, they have to fight, move away from enemies, find food or find a safe place to live. Also, we use some animals to lift weight, carry loads, pull carts, plow fields, and all such activities require energy. And the think of machine, the list the machines that you have come across. What do they need for their working? Yes, why do some engines require fuel like petrol and diesel? Why do living beings and machine need energy to do work? So, what is a work? So, what is a work? There is a difference in way we use the term way in day-to-day life and the way we use it in science. So to make this point clear, let us consider a few examples. Okay, so for example, there is a one boy, Kamli, you can take another name also, Ram also, is preparing for the examination. And he spent a lot of time in study. And he reads books, draw diagram, organize her thoughts, collect questions paper, attend classes. Understand? So it means he... expend a lot of energy on these activity in common words you can say he is a working hard and all this hard work may involve a very little work if we go by the scientific definition of work in common way she is a very hard working she is a very do hard work so you are working hard to push a huge rock let us say the rock does not move despite all that of effort so you get completely exhausted however you may not done any work on the rope as there is no displacement if there is no displacement if you push the rope if the rope is not displaced so it means inside you are not doing the work if there is no displacement so you have not done any work So student, in scientific way, the work is said to be done with a force act on an object and the object is displaced in the direction of force. When you apply the force on an object, if an object displaced, so you are doing the work, you have done the work. But the object cannot move, so you have not done work. Understand what I am saying? So displacement is very necessary for the doing work. Understand what I am saying? So work is said to be done when a force act on an object and the object is displaced in the direction of force. So what is the force? What is the force? Push or pull? And what is the work? The work done on an object is a product of force applied and displacement. In other words, it is a product of force and displacement. What is the work? Work done on an object is the product of force applied and the displacement. It means in scientific way. We are using the verb, this definition of the verb in scientific way. If there is no displacement, so you have not done work. If displacement, if you are push the rock, if you you are playing, you are something do, and your displacement is there, so you have done the work. Okay, understand what I am saying? So work done is equal to force multiply displacement, you can see. And what is the unit of the work? Joule. What is the unit of the work? Joule. And now you tell me, what is the unit of the force? Newton. And what is the unit of the displacement? Meter. So unit of the work is Newton meter. What is the unit of the work? Newton meter. Or you can say that the unit of the work is joule. And 1 joule is equal to 1 Newton meter. So if F is 1 Newton, understand what I am saying? If F, force is 1 Newton, displacement is 1 meter, then the work done is 1 Newton meter or 1 joule. What, understand? What is the unit of the work? Joule. Okay. And if we talk about, in other words, 1 joule is equal to 1 Newton meter, so what is the unit of the force? 1 Newton. And what is the unit of the displacement? Meter. So 1 Newton is equal to 1 joule. So F is 1 Newton and displacement is 1 meter. Then the work done is 1 Newton meter or 1 joule. So 1 joule is the amount of work. What is the define of the 1 joule? Underline this point. So 1 joule is the amount of work done when a force of a Newton displaced on an object by a 1 meter. What is the work? What is the 1 joule? 1 joule means when you, 1 joule is the amount of work. 1 joule kya hai? Amount of work hai when you apply a force 1 Newton. When apply a force 1 Newton, jab aap apply karoge 1 Newton ka force, then the object will displace by 1 meter. Understand what I am saying? So the 1 joule is the amount of work done when a force of 1 Newton displaces an object by 1 meter. So there is a one example you can see. If a force of 1 Newton act on an object is displaced through 2 meter in the direction of force, then the work done is. So you can see there is a force is given and there is a displacement is given. So what is the formula of the work? Work done is equal to force multiplied displacement. So what is the value of the force? 5 Newton. And what is the value of the displacement? 2 meter. So you can multiply 5 multiplied 2 is equal to 10 Newton meter or joule. Understand what I am saying? So I hope you understand. So there is a very simple, in scientific way, if there is no displacement, if there is object does not move, so you have not done. If I am sitting, and if I am reading, and if I am, so this is, you can note, this is the work. So for work there should be displacement. Okay students? Okay, now student, we will discuss the work done by a force. Jo work done ho raha hai force hai, wo may be positive or negative. If the work done by a force is positive, if the force and displacement in same direction, agar jo force bhi aur same jo displacement hai wo bhi same direction mein hai, on that way the work done by a force is positive. When the force and displacement are in same direction, so work done by a force is positive. If the force and displacement in opposite direction, it means one force is right side and displacement is left side, in opposite direction, so work done will be negative. And when there is no displacement, so what will happen? So there is no work, so work done will be zero. So when the work done by a force is zero, if the force is perpendicular to the displacement, परपेंडिकुलर का क्या मतलब है? 90 डिग्री का एंगल होगा ना बेटे. तो फॉर एग्जांपल, व्हेन वी लिफ्ट एन ऑब्जेक्ट द मूव अपवर्ड इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ द फोर्स. अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट आई एम सेइंग? जब हम एक चीज को हमने ऊपर पकड़ रखा है और हम अपवर्ड डायरेक्शन में फोर्स कर रहे हैं, सो द वर्क डन इज द पॉजिटिव. बट देर इज़ अ फोर्स ऑफ ग्रेविटी एक्टिंग डाउनवर्ड ऑन द ऑब्जेक्ट. जब हम नीचे की तरफ जा, जो फोर्स लग रहा है ग्रेविटी का वो नीचे की तरफ चल रहा है, तो जो वर्क डन है, द वर्क डन बाय द फोर्स ऑफ ग्रेविटी इज नेगेटिव. अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट आई एम सेइंग? व्हेन वी लिफ्ट एन ऑब्जेक्ट, द ऑब्जेक्ट मूव अपवर्ड इन द डायरेक्शन. हियर द वर्क डन इज पॉजिटिव एंड बट देर इज अ फोर्स ऑफ ग्रेविटी एक्टिंग डाउनवर्ड ऑन द ऑब्जेक्ट, सो द वर्क डन बाय द फोर्स ग्रेविटी इज नेगेटिव. ओके, नाउ यू कैन से देर इज अ पोर्टर लिफ्ट अ लगेज. अंडरस्टैंड दिस, देर इज अ न्यूमेरिकल. एक पोर्टर है, वो लिफ्ट कर रहा है लगेज को, तो जो लगेज है उसका जो वेट है वो कितना है? 15 kg है. 15 kg. ओके, तो अ पोर्टर लिफ्ट अ लगेज ऑफ 15 kg फ्रॉम द ग्राउंड एंड पुट्स इट्स ऑन हिज हेड 1.5 meters अबव द ग्राउंड. मास इज गिवन and displacement is given to calculate the work done by him on the luggage. Okay, so acceleration due to gravity, yahan par hum formula lagayenge, acceleration due to gravity 10 m/s². to work done formula kya hoga hamara? W is equal to F multiply S. to what is the formula of the F? F is equal to mg. it means a porter lift a luggage. mass is given, luggage ka mass kitna hai? 15 kg hai. और वो अपने हेड तक चला ग्राउंड से 1.5 मीटर हो, तो यहाँ पर हमारी ग्रेविटी के अकॉर्डिंग भी तो होगा ना. तो यहाँ पर जो हम एक्सेलरेशन यूज़ करेंगे वो यूज़ करेंगे एक्सेलरेशन ड्यू टू ग्रेविटी. द वैल्यू ऑफ द एक्सेलरेशन ड्यू टू ग्रेविटी 10 m/s², यू कैन टेक द 9.8 m/s². एंड वट इज़ द फॉर्मूला ऑफ द एफ? इज इक्वल टू एम जी. एम इज़ गिवन, जी इज़ गिवन. Okay, and displacement is given, so you can multiply and the answer will be 225 Nm or 225 kg. Understand what I am saying? So students, I hope you understand. We have discussed today the work, what is the work in scientific way, and we have work positive work. If the force and displacement are in same direction, so it will be positive. If the force and displacement in opposite direction, so it will be negative. If there is no displacement, so force, so work will be zero. So I hope you understand, students. Okay, students. Bye.